Schools closing down in inner cities across America.
Shit. Rello, I gotta tell you, man, I look at that as like it's taking so much away from the community because we barely got kids wanting to go to school anyway. You know, and then to strip them just of the school period, which is the landmark, it's a safe haven. Because in the inner city, we got, you in the ghetto, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, kids, you know, they need that time to go somewhere and just be away from the hood. Like, when you leave out the door in St. Louis, as a kid, you know what I'm saying? Especially, like, growing up in that 90s, you were seeing all type of stuff going on. So niggas on the corner selling dope. I'm talking this, you know, 7, 8 in the morning, getting it in. You know what I'm saying? Then you got shootings happening when you getting off the bus. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. It's like the Wild Wild West. So closing the city schools, you know what I'm saying? It's like deleting just a little bit of our safe haven, a little bit of our getaway.
I feel like when you close down the school in the inner city, you is taking away from our safe haven, and it is already like producing unproductivity because like we ain't going to school already from the time a child wakes up in the morning, they have idle minds. So we ain't going to school, and the school is closing down. We got an idle mind to play around in the neighborhood. And the things we once seen while we was in school, we are now available to see those things. We're now available to do those things, experiment, and be curious. And once your mind reaches a level of curiosity, then you tend to act on it. So with the schools being closed down, we really ain't got that support and that distraction that's positive that's having us learning. We learning something that we don't need to be learning. Then that too can cause us to grow up in a trend a fast living to where we may pick up on drugs, may pick up on partying, may pick up on trying to be something we not when we need to be going to school. The school is closing down, it's taken away from our parents, that's our teachers, principals, counselors, that's money being taken away from the community, meaning that they forced to be at home, they forced to be dealing with stuff they weren't usually dealing with, so it's like a chain reaction that's gonna happen, like a downhill collision of bad things. And the kids suffering and the parents suffering. So if both of them suffering, it's a unit. And then if two or three or four schools get closed, that's we talking at least 1,000 people that's either going out of jobs and that's on the streets or is at home just being idle and ready to do whatever to make it happen. Mm-hmm. So if I can rate that on a scale of 1 to 10, being 10 being the most, I have to rate that as the whole 10, bro.
Yeah. Just that affects everything. And you know what I'm saying? Got to do with social development and just our community. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. And that's a deep question, Rello. For real.
And thanks for asking.
Shouts out to you, boy, Rello Band from Jacksonville. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, what's up? It's your boy Yero.
Your boy Kevy Kev.
For real. With random topics.
Random TV.
And random ass times, my nigga.
Any given time.
So tune in.
So we'll be covering topics based off of what you would like to talk about, what he would like to talk about, what I would like to talk about, what your kids would like to talk about.
Yeah.
If your dog can talk, we'll talk about what he want to talk about.
Do speak, dog but needs.
The main time, with the main thing we're gonna be covering for real is the issue really with life, you know. And don't nobody know the answer to life, you know. certain things is really made without a meaning or no operation or no process, it's just there. You know? And in my point of view right now, this could see the introduction so random, it turned into a motherfucking debate already, because I think
it's just random.
You know? We had a topic where we was like, how the pyramids was made, yeah? I don't know how they was made. You don't know how they was made. I don't think he know how they was made. But they was made. We get in on this conversation. It's live, hear me?
You live for the kid.
Well, I guess we can hear your voice, though. Until you. And so, you know, another thing I want to say, man, we young, black, and out of control. Educated and on the go. Sometimes I be feeling like I want to start a revolution. A modern day revolution, for real, for real. We need some change to go on. We need shit to happen. More so like, We need change. But we ain't talking about no dollar change. We ain't talking about no change for no dollar.
No quarterbacks.
We talking about straight changing yourself. Like at the time where like you can be forced to change, and then you can change on your own. But the change on your own is harder than being forced to change, because being forced to change is easy, because you're doing something that's already been told to do. And you know the consequences behind not doing it. But when you're changing your own, you gotta come up with your sacrifice. You gotta state your sacrifice. You're like, I'm gonna sacrifice this in order to do that. It's like mind over matter. Matter over mind.
Change is crazy. You know what I'm saying? Change involves a lot of first-time things, you know what I'm saying? New feelings, you know. You get the butterflies when you start talking. When niggas be talking about change, niggas be like, man. You had niggas that be like, you got dudes who sell drugs, you know what I'm saying? And then been in prison like 4 or 5 times. And know it ain't, it's a dead-end pathway. And still, like, when you see his homie change, and then he get invited to change, he gets so scared because he don't know what's on the other side.